I smell a nest. Gotta be right here. Gotta be close to a nest. Whew, I can smell it. Another mobile medical unit. Oh, I gotta find a way inside. See if there's another injector. Could make something out of this. Now where is it? God damn this. It's gotta be close. Done. Oh, freaks. Now it'll be safe and right through here. Figures. lock tight. Won't open. God damn it. Fuse blown. Wait, no, not this way. Nothing like scrap. Feels, yes. Now we're in business. Let's do it. Okay, let's see what we got in here. Yeah, a Nero injector. Let's see if it still works. Better living through chemistry. Micro recorder, hello. God damn it.
St. John to Lost Lake Infirmary.
O'Brien, I'm at one of your beacons.
Which one?
What do you mean, which one? This Nero radio has a GPS, doesn't it?
Yes, of course it does. Okay. You're at Olali Falls. Okay, good. Keep an eye out. A field op is going to be there any minute. O'Brien out.
O'Brien? Oh, God damn it. O'Brien, come in. Your friends are here. O'Brien.
I told you, they're not my friends. Okay, head in on foot.
Yeah, I know. What do you want me to do?
Use
one of these tracking devices.
Now.
Not this time. I'm already tracking this one.
Standing by.
Follow the researcher. She's there to investigate an infected subject. The freak that was tagged in a nearby cave.
A cave? You want me to follow armed Nero goons into a cave?
Just stay close to her. While you're in range, I can intercept her data.
Well, Brian...
I'm still working on the info you want. Don't ask.
Why the hell am I talking to you?
O'Brien out.
Sound off. Lock down.
All good.
All clear. We good?
We're all set. I know I heard something.
O'Brien, come in. I've got the data.
Receiving it now. Thank you, Drifter.
What the hell is she talking about, O'Brien? About this virus, whatever the hell it is, or what it's doing. I want to know what the hell's going on, O'Brien. Why are they out here? What the fuck are you doing? O'Brien.
Okay. I'll be in touch. O'Brien out.
Oh, boy, this is gonna get up fast. Oh, what the hell happened here? Oh, no. I wonder if they left anything worth the effort. Addy, you there? Deacon St. John to Lost Lake Infirmary. Come back.
Deke! Hey. Feeling a little out of it, you know? You okay? What's going on?
Boozer. Hey. Nothing. I get tired of listening to the radio-free Oregon. It only takes so much of his truth or bullshit, you know?
Deke, Addy told me how I'd be dead if it weren't for you. Getting the NI, whatever the fucks.
Boozer,
it must have been fun. Hold me down while she fucking wiped away at me. Remember how, Jack carved up that turkey last time we was all together? He kept slipping all over the goddamn table.
Yeah, Booze, man.
Still feel it, you know? Life. Worse than the Rippers. If you hadn't been there to hold me down, I don't know what would happen to
you. It's time, loser. It's not so long.
Sorry, I'm feeling a little woozy.
Hey, Addie's gonna kill me if she finds out you're at a bad fucking route.
Yeah, I hear a bunk calling my name.
One of the biker
boys. Lost Lake signing off.
Open up.
I want to... Listen, Boozer. Ricky, you said you had a job for me?
Hey, Deke. Yeah. You remember Shane Riley? Everyone called him Red?
Red Riley. Yeah, never heard of him, but let me guess. Ginger?
What, red hair? No. It was his boots. He wore these rattlesnake boots dyed with god-awful red color. He made quite the impression.
No, I bet.
Anyway, he used to do runs for us back in the day until one day he decides he didn't like the camp credits we were paying. So he up and kills Lindsay Fuller.
Who?
Lindsay. Worked supply before Blair?
Wait a second, so he killed an unarmed woman?
Oh, she was armed. She just wasn't expecting him to shoot her in the face. Will you listen? So Red murders her, cleans out her supply hut, and then takes off before anyone knows what's happened. Got away clean.
Oh, that son of a bitch.
Until now. He and his men have been spotted up at Camp Pioneer.
You don't gotta ask. I got this thing about him.
About killing unarmed women. I know. So I knew you'd want to handle it.
Yeah, like I said, I got this covered. What else can you tell me about him?
Not much. Oh, wait. He chews tobacco. I heard he was such an addict that he rounds up cigarette butts, takes out the tobacco, and chews that.
Well, that's disgusting. So now I got two reasons to kill him.
Yeah, but be careful, Deke.
Let him in.
Deacon.
Hey, Zanny.
Bike's a real guzzler. See you around.
I'll get the game.
Yeah.
Hey, me again.
So, I took Boozer into the Lost Lake camp, and...
I know.
I know, I told you I was never going back there with Iron Mike threatening to break my neck and all, but didn't have a choice. See, Boozer was gonna die, and, well, he still didn't want to go. Hell, I didn't want to go, but, like I said, didn't have a choice. Neither of us did, so it didn't matter. He lost the arm anyway, and now he's stuck. I mean, we're stuck.
Goddamn schizo. You know, I can't remember if I told you about this clown, but he's the kind of asshole that's glad all this shit went down. He says he was gangbanging in Sacramento and Fresno. I don't remember, but he says he's not from around here, and he's not. Claims he was dealing drugs and guns from California to Oregon, and then everything went to hell. And you know what? I think he's full of shit. To me, he kind of looks like a frat boy, like he was on the lacrosse team peddling sodas at a mini mart. No, man. He would have had a cushy job at his old man's accounting firm making copies and getting everyone their morning coffee, you know, making more in a day than I've ever made in a week. You know, it's this game the Boozer and I used to play before we rode out of Lost Lake for good. We used to call it, Who You Were. You know, we'd look at someone, we'd try to guess who they were before the shit went down, you know? You know, I met a few drug addicts, a lot of ex-cons, no accountants. So, that makes sense, if you think about it. First couple of weeks after the shit went down, I mean, Jesus, that was a freak show. There's no way some accountant or pencil pusher lived through that shit, so I don't know, maybe Schizo's telling the truth. I'm not sorry that you missed it. I'm not.
Anyway, Boozer and I wanted to head north and get away from all this shit, but that ain't happening anytime soon, or happening ever. Hey, look on the bright side. Looks like you're stuck with me. Okay. I'll stop by later. See you.
Seen him before. Open up. Big.
Hey, Ricky, I'm a Camp Pioneer in this goddamn war zone.
What's going on? Are any of our guys there?
Right now. No, I don't think so. Sounds like they're clearing freaks. Don't worry. I'll find this guy. Deacon out. All right, Red, where the hell are you? Newts. Wow, they're killing newts. Okay, what's this? Okay, yes, cigarette butts, yes.
Freaks!
These look like,
Hey, how'd we do? I think we're okay.
That's tobacco's bed. Red Riley, you are one gross Mike. Motherfucker. More boot prints, yeah, this way.
what's in here.
Oh, good. Urine. Jesus.
Well, if you gotta go, you gotta go. He's gotta be here somewhere. hiding in one of these shacks.
One that I shot? Mouthing off me. See, really. You should know. Shit off. I told you. Shut the hell up. I'm gonna shoot you.
Come on, Red. Come on out.
Gate. Open it up. Any trouble, we throw your ass.
I used to be a cop.
Farewell.
Here for your bike?
Having a look. Is that okay?
Probably draining a lot of gas riding the broken road. Need fuel? Don't beat her up too bad.
No idea how
to. Let me know if you need anything.
Hey, Ricky. I got him.
Deacon. What a relief. Lindsay has some folks she was close to. I'll let him know.
Yeah, okay. I'll see you around, Ricky.
We had some of those.
Need any help over there?
I've been, thinking about what you were saying about doing something to make a difference around here, pay back the camp.
I'm listening.
Do you got a few minutes? I want to show you something.
Yeah, guess I can spare you a minute or two.
So where are we heading?
You ever been up to the caves north of the lake?
I know. Come on. See if you can keep up.
Okay. Let's go.
I got marsh duty anyway this morning. Gotta see if any freaks are stuck in the muck out that way.
When's the last time you went up there?
Been a few years, I guess. When I was a boy, we used to live in that damn cave. That old man sort of fancied himself a geologist.
Sounds like we got a couple. Freaks stuck in the mud, I mean.
Yeah, sounds like it. Here, let me take care of them.
All right. I guess I can let you do that. Nice work. I think Schizo's just found a new man for the job.
You know what Schizo can go do.
Anyway, as I was saying,
we spent hours talking about how all these caves were formed when lava flows would harden on the outside, but the molten cores would still flow like buried rivers. You got the big caves that drew in the tourists, like Metolius up there, and there's way more than that, riddled all over these parts.